So the analyze stage is really all about profiling the whole application, looking not just at the kernels that you intend to parallelize, but looking at the whole thing and trying to figure out where can this application benefit from parallelization, right? And how much can you expect to benefit? So once you've decided that there's a region of the code that you need to parallelize, of course, there's different approaches to doing this. Certainly no code is better than the code you don't have to write at all. So if you can find that there's a parallel library for the GPU that already does exactly what you want, then great, you're done. You can simply call out to that library. Sometimes you have a lot of code and you want to be able to instrument it. You want to do a minimal amount of work to get a little bit of parallelization. And there's an approach for this called directives. The most well-known one on the CPU is called OpenMP. There's another cross-platform standard called OpenACC, which has emerged, which ACC stands for accelerator. This is sort of an extension of OpenMP to encompass the ideas of accelerators like the GPU. And so if you're looking at GPU programming, OpenACC is a really lightweight way to experiment with it. But of course, sometimes what you want to do is actually go in and write a parallel routine. And naturally, that's what we've been focusing on throughout this course using CUDA C++. So of course, we're gonna focus here. So assuming that you're going to be coding something up from scratch for this purpose, the next choice is how to pick an algorithm. And this is a huge deal. This is your real chance to make a huge improvement. Pick the right algorithm. So all the bit twiddling optimization in the world won't gain you nearly as much as choosing the right sort of fundamentally parallel-friendly algorithm. I'll give a couple of simple examples in this unit, and you'll see more examples in Unit 6. There's no recipe for picking the right algorithm. What you need to do is sort of think deeply about what is the parallelism in your problem. But we'll try to give you a few examples of that so that you have a little practice. So once you've decided how to parallelize your algorithm, then you want to optimize the code. And there will be sort of a cycle between these. As you'll see in the example, you try a parallelization, study how well it does, you know, suggest some changes that might suggest a way that you approach the parallelization differently. So we're really talking about profile-driven optimization, by which I mean measure it. Measure how fast things are going, and use that to base your decisions. Don't just sort of take a guess at what's going to work well and what doesn't. And finally, the deploy step. So, you know, look, in this class, we do these little homeworks, and they're fairly self-contained so that you can get them done in a reasonable amount of time. So the process of actually deploying a GPU-accelerated code into real use is not going to come up a lot in this class. So consider this just sort of free software engineering advice. You know, when you're working on a real code, it's a really, really bad idea to optimize in a vacuum. And what I mean by this is that you can easily spend tons of time adding tons of unnecessary complexity to your code, speeding up a kernel way past the point where it's no longer a bottleneck. And it's just fundamentally a good idea to push any improvements through to the end code. You're making it real by doing that. And making it real as soon as possible ensures that you're running and profiling and parallelizing and optimizing real workloads. And the other thing to remember is that, you know, even small improvements are useful. If you make your code 50% faster or 2 times faster or 4 times faster, that's useful. And you can push it out to the users of your code. You can start employing it and making it real. Even if you think that there's a factor of 20 times speed up in the wings. You know, really the advice here again is be disciplined, you know, analyze what you're doing, you know, decide how you're going to parallelize it, decide how you're going to optimize it by studying that code, you know, and measuring it using profile-driven optimization. And finally, you know, be sure to deploy frequently, okay? So deploy early and often. Remember that this whole thing is intended to be a cycle.